Yo YouTube, what's up? I'm Tim, and this is Cash Kelly and AC Sports Report. So I'm feeling a little better, and I am here to try and back up my 12-4 performance last week. I mean, I was all over YouTube with my 12-4. If you ain't running with it, start running from it. Because my picks are good stuff. Let's get on to them then. Baltimore at Cleveland, game one. I'm going to give me Baltimore in this one. Cleveland hasn't been terrible in the first two games, but look who they've played. Baltimore's offense should wake up in this game because Lord knows they haven't the first two games. Game two, Cincy at Carolina. Give me Cincy in this one. The bottom line with Cincinnati and Carolina is Carolina's throwing Jimmy Clausen out there his first game. I'm never going to pick a team in their first game with a new quarterback. Now, I might make some exceptions, but Jimmy Clausen never blew me away in college to begin with, so I'm not sure what he's going to do in the NFL. Give me Cincy in this one. I think that it should be a day where T.O. and Ocho Cinco, Batman and Robin, whatever the hell you want to call these guys, has a good game. Next game, Dallas at Houston. This should be a fun one. The Battle of Texas. Not the Red River Rivalry, but the Battle of Texas. Give me Dallas in this one, and here's why. Dallas is not going to start 2-0. I mean, hell, Wade Phillips' job could be up if they start 0-3. Not even lying. I mean, Jerry Jones has that Super Bowl in Dallas this year, and you better believe he has every intention of the Dallas Cowboys playing in the Super Bowl this year. I don't know why he has that intention, but he does. So Dallas, I think, wins that one. San Francisco at Kansas City, next one. Another 0-2 team. Kansas City is 2-0, as a genius named Tim Kelly predicted. But San Francisco is just a better team here. Kansas City, they beat San Diego, but last week they didn't have a real tough opponent. Give me the Niners. I think they got to wake up this week. Alex Smith better wake up real quick, or he's not going to be having a job too much longer. It amazes me how he's still a starting quarterback in the NFL. Detroit at Minnesota, next game, Minnesota. Brett Favre's going to come out in this one. Hopefully for Vikings fans, get his interceptions under control. Should be a good game for them. Give me Minnesota. They should carve up Detroit. If not, all day Adrian Peterson should be running the ball. Next game, New England at Buffalo. New England, I mean, it's at New England, they're playing Buffalo, Tom Brady, Randy Moss. Buffalo's basically got nothing. New England should take this game easily. Next game, Atlanta at New Orleans. That's a tough one. Atlanta just hasn't impressed me that much. I'll take New Orleans. I mean, they impressed me with 41-7 last week. But they were playing a Cardinals, a team, in my opinion, is one of the top two or three worst teams in the NFL this year. I'll take New Orleans in this one. Another 3-0 start from them. Next game, New Orleans at the New York Football Giants, as Chris Berman likes to say. Yeah, I'll take Tennessee in this one. Here's why. Vince Young has a lot to prove this week. I'm not a Giants hater. I mean, honestly, out of all the teams in the NFC East, obviously, I like the Eagles. I could care less what the Giants do. I could care less for the most part what the Redskins do, too. And the Cowboys are really the team I hate. The Giants, you know, if we're playing them, great. I hope we beat them. But I've never had a reason to hate the Giants, so it's not me hating the Giants. But I think Vince Young always does well in a game. He has to prove a lot. His job is on the line. Kerry Collins could very well come in there and do better than what he's done so far. Next game, Pittsburgh at Tampa Bay. Both 2-0, but let's be honest, Tampa Bay has played Carolina and Cleveland. Give me the Steelers. I wouldn't be surprised if they shut them out. Their defense has just been absolutely amazing so far. Charlie Batch or Byron Leftwich. I think Leftwich will start this week. Obviously, Dennis Dixon got injured last week. Leftwich should have a big game. If not, Charlie Batch will have a big game. He looked pretty good last week, actually. Give me the Steelers. Next game. Jeez. Oh, God. Philly at Jacksonville. This is a game that just disgusts me. That's the bottom line. It disgusts me because I just don't even think the Eagles have a direction of their franchise anymore. And as a fan, that's tough to take. I'm going to take the Eagles in this one because they're just a better team than Jacksonville. I don't think it matters who's throwing the ball in this game. The Eagles will win. And maybe McCoy will have another big game. Washington at St. Louis. Give me Washington. You really think Washington's going to lose to the Rams? No, they're not. McNabb's been solid so far. Give me Washington this one. Oakland at Arizona. Whew. Two bad teams. But give me Oakland in this one. I mean, the Cardinals are a mess. They almost lost to the Rams week one. Derek Anderson's a mess. They should have given that job to Matt Liner in the first place, which I said. So, obviously, my pick would be Oakland, who didn't look terrible last week. Indy at Denver next game. I love what Josh McDaniels does in these big games, but Indy's going to win. With Elvis Dumervil, Peyton Manning really isn't going to have too much to compete with on this defense. He should be able to throw short passes to Dallas Clark, avoid the Champ Baileys and Brian Dawkins in the secondary, and just work this team down the field the whole game. I don't think it'll be very high scoring, but I think they'll win. Next game, we got San Diego at Seattle. I think I'm going to take San Diego in this game. Phillip Rivers looked pretty solid last week. The Chargers looked solid last week overall. They wrecked. Give me the Chargers in this one. I just don't think Seattle is all that good. I mean, look at them. Final Sunday game, the Sunday night one. New York Jets, the Hard Knocks at Miami. Look, I said at the beginning I thought the Jets would make the playoffs. I mean, I've been starting to question that. I'm not one of the people that sat here and said they're going to win the Super Bowl like most of you guys did. Because I thought that was completely, completely silly and foolish. Jets aren't making the Super Bowl. And they're not winning this game either. Miami's winning this game. Chad Henne looked pretty decent last week. The Dolphins' defense looked pretty good. Dolphins have a pretty decent team. The running game scares you a little because they got two pretty up there in age running backs. But remember, Ricky Williams lost a few years with his retirement and marijuana and all that stuff. Miami wins this game. Final game, Green Bay at Chicago in Soldier Field. Green Bay's 1-1. Chicago is 2-0. But Green Bay is just a better team than Chicago, really. I think it's going to be a tough call on this one. But give me Chicago, actually. I think Green Bay is a better team, but Aaron Rodgers did not look good week one on the road. The Bears' defense looks back. Brian Urlacher, they got Julius Peppers in there now. Give me the Bears in this one. It's not my gut feeling, but I just think that's going to happen for some strange reason. And on those strange reason picks, I've been good so far. Find me on Twitter, Cash Kelly NAC, Facebook, Cash Kelly NAC Sports Support, YouTube, MrKellstar. Email me cashcallynac@gmail.com. Oh yeah, AC is probably returning to the show in a week or so. I never fired him like you guys all thought. He was just really busy with playing in a bunch of sports and stuff. He'll be back soon. I'm Tim. I'll catch you guys later. Go watch some NFL and live your life. Shake someone's hand. I'll see you.